Okay, so today we're going to be taking a look at fractional indices. So when we have a fraction for an indice, the denominator actually denotes the root that we have to take, and then the numerator shows what power we then have to raise it to. So for this first example, we have 16 to the power of a half. The 2's on the bottom, so that means we have to find the square root of 16, and then we have to raise that to the numerator, we have to raise it to the power of 1. So for any fractional indice that has a 1 on the numerator, all we have to do is find the root that's shown by the denominator. So again, for this first example, I have 16 to the power of a half, so I have a 2 on the denominator, so I've got to find the square root. So I'm looking for the square root of 16, which is equal to 4. And then as I said before, we'd have to raise that to the numerator, we'd raise it to the power of 1, but again, that wouldn't change anything, so all we have to write is 4. Okay, for this next question, we have 125 to the power of a third. Again, because we have a fractional indice, we have to find the root that's denoted by the denominator. So this time it's going to be a cube root because we have a 3 on the bottom. So we're looking for the cube root of 125. Well, the cube root of 125 is actually 5. And that would be our final answer because, again, we have a 1 on the numerator. If we raise this to the power of 1, it'd still give us 5. Okay, feel free to pause the video here and have a go at these questions, and we'll go through them in just a few seconds. Okay, for our first example, we have 144 to the power of a half. So again, I know that's going to be my square root because the 2's on the bottom. So the square root of 144 is equal to 12. For our next question, we have 343 to the power of a third. So because our 3's on the bottom this time, we know it's going to be our cube root. So we're going to do the cube root of 343. So the cube root of 343 is equal to 7. Okay, for our next question, we've got 8 to the power of 10, then raised to the power of a half. So this actually means the square root of 8 to the power of 10. But this also links back into our laws of indices. We did a video on this not too long ago. If you want to check that video out, I'll leave a link in the description and also a card in the top right corner. So going back to our laws of indices, when we have a power raised to another power, we actually multiply the indices. So I have 8 to the power of 10, then raised to the power of a half. All I need to do is multiply my indices together. So I have 10 multiplied by a half. So 10 multiplied by a half is 5. So that would be 8 to the power of 5. And that makes sense because as we were talking about before, this actually meant the square root of 8 to the power of 10. So the square root of 8 to the power of 10 is 8 to the power of 5. Because if we take 8 to the power of 5 and multiply it by itself, 8 to the power of 5 again, going back to our laws of indices, when we multiply a term, we add the powers. So that gives us 8 to the power of 10, which is what we started with right at the beginning. Okay, and for this next example, we've got the same thing. We've got 8 to the power of 4 times b to the power of 6, all raised to the power of a half. So technically we're doing the square root of a to the power of 4 times b to the power of 6, but we can just apply our laws of indices. So because we have a term raised to a power, which is then raised to another power, we're going to multiply the indices. So for our term of a, I'd have a to the power of 4, then raised to the power of a half. So I'm going to do 4 times a half, which is 2. So that would be a squared. And then for our term of b to the power of 6, we then raise that to the power of a half. So I multiply the indices together. So 6 multiplied by a half would actually give me 3. So that would be b cubed. Okay, if you had a go at them and got them right, well done. Let's have a look at some more difficult examples. Okay, so for our next example, we have a fractional indice where the numerator isn't actually 1. So for these types of questions, we have to do what we talked about right at the beginning. So for 64 to the power of 2/3, what that means is I've got to find the cube root of 64, and then I have to raise that to the power of 2, or I have to square it. So we're going to have the cube root of 64, which we're then going to square. So the cube root of 64 is 4, and then we have to square that, which gives us 16. So 64 to the power of 2/3 is actually 16. Okay, we can do something similar for the next question. We've got 16 raised to the power of 3/4. So again, we have to find the root of the bottom. So we have to find the 4th root of 16. And then in this case, we have to cube it. So I can rewrite this as the 4th root of 16, which then we have to cube. Well, the fourth root of 16 is 2, and then I have to cube that, so 2 cubed gives me 8. So 16 to the power of 3 quarters would give us 8. Okay, we're going to look at some more questions now, so feel free to pause the video here if you want to have a go at these, and we'll go through the answers in just a few seconds. Okay, for our first question, 243 to the power of 3 fifths. So because I've got my 5 on the bottom, that means I'm going to find my fifth root of 243. And then I'm going, whatever I get for that, we need to cube it. So the fifth root of 243 is actually 3, which we then need to cube. So 3 cubed is 27. Okay, for 625 to the power of 3 quarters, that means we have to find the fourth root of 625, and then whatever we get for that, we have to cube it. So the fourth root of 625 is actually 5, which then we need to cube, so 5 cubed gives us 125. Okay, for this next question we have 64, a to the power of 6, b to the power of 9, all raised to the power of 2/3. So what we're going to do for this one is take every part of this expression and raise it to the power of 2/3. Okay, so to begin with, we'd have 64 to the power of 2/3. So we do the cube root of 64, which is 4. We then have to square it, so 4 squared gives us 16. We then have a to the power of 6, which we're going to raise to the power of 2/3. So again, going back to our laws of indices, when we raise a power to a new power, we have to multiply the indices. So this would be a to the power of, we do 6 times 2/3, so 6 times 2 is 12, so we'd have 12 over 3, which is just 4, so that would be a to the power of 4. And then finally, for our term of b to the power of 9, we'd also raise that to the power of 2/3, so again, with our laws of indices, raising a power to a new power, we multiply the indices. So we'd have b to the power of, we'd do 9 times 2/3, so 9 times 2 is 18. We'd have 18 over 3, which simplifies to just 6. So we'd have b to the power of 6. So our final answer for this one, fully simplified, would be 16, a to the power of 4, b to the power of 6. And for our last question, we have 625, a to the 12, b to the 8, c to the 16, all raised to the power of 3/4. So just like the previous question, we're going to take each individual part of this expression and raise it to the power of 3/4. So starting with the 625, I'd have 625 raised to the power of 3/4. So for that, we'd do the fourth root of 625, which is 5. We'd then need to cube that, so 5 cubed is 125. Okay, for this next part we'd have a to the power of 12, which we then raise to the power of 3 over 4. So again, multiplying our indices, that'd give us a to the power of, we'd do 12 times 3/4, so 12 times 3 is 36, so we'd have 36 over 4, which is 9, so that'd be a to the power of 9. We'd then have b to the power of 8, which we'd then raise to the power of 3/4. So multiplying the indices again, we'd have b to the power of, well, 8 times 3 is 24. So we'd have 24 over 4, which is just 6. So that would be b to the power of 6. And then finally, we'd have c to the power of 16, which we'd raise to the power of 3/4. So again, multiplying the indices, we'd do 16 times 3 over 4. Well, 16 times 3 is 48. So we'd have c to the 48 over 4. Which just simplifies to c to the power of 12. So if we look for those individual components, we have 125, a to the power of 9, b to the power of 6, c to the power of 12. And that would be our final answer. Again, 125, a to the 9, b to the 6, c to the 12. So a big well done if you had a go at them and got them right. And that's it for today's video. I hope you found it useful. If you did, please feel free to leave a like and consider subscribing. If there are at all any specific topics that you'd like me to go through next, then please just let me know down in the comments. So thank you very much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.